Chapter 1, Introduction to Heat Transfer. Let's define heat transfer first. Heat transfer is a scientific discipline where we study the heat, an energy form that can travel from a higher temperature material body to a lower temperature material body due to temperature difference. There are four implications. The first implication is when, under what condition we will witness a heat transfer process. The answer is whenever there's a temperature difference, there's heat flow. For example, a rod is inserted into the fire. At one end, temperature is 200 degrees. At the other end, the temperature is 20. So there's a temperature difference, then there's a heat flow. The second implication is where the heat transfer takes place, or in which direction. According to the law, second law of thermodynamics, the heat flow always moves from a higher temperature location to a lower temperature location. And it is in the direction of decreasing temperature. So you have learned that heat flow has direction, and it is represented by the arrow. It points to the decreasing temperature. The third implication is about how much heat is transferred. We need to define heat variable. There are five of them. The first variable is heat, which is an energy form that we feel as hot or cold. It is represented by capital Q with the unit joule. The second variable is heat rate, which is the amount of heat transfer per unit time. It is represented by lowercase q with the unit W. You have studied these two variables in details in your previous course of thermodynamics. But there's one point I want to emphasize. Let's go to the illustration. A slab with one surface at temperature 80, with the other surface temperature at 70. So there's a temperature difference, then there's heat flow. The heat rate really represents the heat flow that goes through the whole surface area A. Keep this point in mind. The third variable is heat flux, which is heat rate per unit surface area. It is represented by Q double prime with the unit watt per meter square. The difference between heat rate and heat flux is that heat rate represents the heat flow that goes through the whole surface area. Heat flux, on the other hand, only represents the heat flow that goes through a specific point on the surface area. Of course, it can be any point on the surface area of your interest. The fourth heat variable is heat rate per unit length. It is represented by Q single prime with the unit watt per meter. Let's define the lengths. We go to this illustration, and you can see this is height, this is the width, and this is length. So heat rate per unit length really represents the heat flow that goes through this line perpendicular to the length. Of course, it can be any line perpendicular to the length of your interest. The last variable is heat rate per unit volume. It is represented by Q triple prime or Q dot with the unit watt per meter cube. Heat rate per unit of volume is similar to the density, which is defined as mass per unit volume. Density is a mass point within the substance volume. It represents how compact the substance is. Similarly, the heat rate per unit volume is a heat point within the substance volume. It represents how dense or how loose the heat is within the substance volume. So far, we have learned 5 heat variables. You should know the meaning, the symbol, the unit for each variable, also the relation between them. Let's move on to the last implication. It is about how heat is transferred. We want to know the heat transfer mechanism behind. There are 3 basic heat transfer modes or mechanisms. The first heat transfer mode is conduction. Conduction is a heat transfer process where heat is transferred within a solid or a stationary fluid with 2 ends at a different temperature. The heat is carried by atoms, molecules, and electrons. The heat transfer mode of conduction can also occur when 2 things at a different temperature come into contact with each other without relative motion. For example, heat flow along the rod is by conduction because the heat is carried by the molecules, the atoms, even though we cannot see them. There's conduction also at the interface between the hand surface and the rod surface. If these two things at a different temperature coming into contact with each other. The second heat transfer mode is convection, which is heat transfer between a solid surface and adjacent moving fluid at a different temperature from the solid surface one. For example, the hot egg surface at 80 degrees, the air blown by fan at 70 degrees, they're contacting with each other. Since there's a temperature difference, then there's heat flow. This heat flow, heat transfer mode, is convection. You can imagine when the air speed is increased, more heat will be carried away from the hot surface by the cool air. On the other hand, if the air is at rest with zero velocity, then we still have heat flow from hot surface into the cool air. But the heat transfer mode would be conduction. The last heat transfer mode is radiation, which is heat transfer between any two surfaces at a different temperature without direct contact. For example, the sun surface temperature almost at 600 Kelvin. The surface temperature is at 300 Kelvin. There's temperature difference, then there's a heat flow. And heat lifts the sun surface. They travel far and they're carried by electromagnetic waves or photons. Photons are energy particle. Finally, they travel all the way and arriving at the surface or Earth. Since this is two surface, do not have direct contact. So the heat transfer mode between these two surfaces must be radiation. You have noticed that we use arrow to represent heat flow direction. You can draw one arrow or several arrows. We also use the symbol Q, Q, single prime, Q double prime to represent how much heat is transferred. Finally, we use the subscript radiation, conduction, convection to represent the heat transfer mode or heat transfer mechanism. In this way, the heat transfer process is clearly visualized and presented. At this point, we covered topic one, what is heat transfer and how heat is transferred. If we do a quick summary, we define heat transfer first, then discuss the four implications from definition of heat transfer, when, where, how much, and how. The objective of topic one is for you to be able to identify all heat transfer modes for heat transfer process and be able to label the heat transfer process with a simple subscript representing heat transfer mode and arrow representing heat flow direction. Next, we will practice. This is example 1-1. You will be asked to identify heat transfer mode for each case. Before we start, a piece of advice. If you want to gain the most from the example, you should pause the video and try on your own. Then compare your notes with the instructors. Okay. The first case is heat transfer between a hot surface and a cold moving fluid. So the heat transfer mode must be convection. The second case is a solid poker with one end at high temperature, other end at low temperature. So the heat flow is within the solid. The heat transfer mode must be conduction. The third case is open channel with vacuum in between. We have upper surface at a lower temperature, bottom surface at higher temperature. There's a temperature difference, then there's heat flow. In between is vacuum, so there's no air, there's no water. Since this is two surfaces at a different temperature, without direct contact each other, so the heat transfer mode must be radiation. The last case is barefoot on a hot surface. This is two fins at a different temperature come into contact with each other. So the heat flow transfer mode must be conduction. Well, there's a bonus for you to practice cold moving air going through an open channel. I will see you next time. We finish topic 1.